let there is a given binomial expansion as a plus x whole to the power n. Okay, now if we expand this, we will find n plus 1 terms, right? So every binomial expansion has middle term, right? Now it depends on the value of n plus 1. If it odd, then the middle term will be only 1. If it's even, then the middle term will be, there will be two middle terms. As let's see, let after expanding a binomial expansion, we get 5 terms, then this is odd, right? So 5 term will be given, found when the power is 4. So this is n equals to 4, then n plus 1 will be 5. Okay, so the middle terms will be, this will be the middle terms. So there is only one middle terms. So when the power is even, the middle terms will be 1. Also, if n equals to 5, then n plus 1 equals to 6, which is even. So let's say, okay, then there is no unique middle terms, right? So these two will be combined middle term. This will be the first middle term and this will be the second middle term. Okay, so we see that if indices of the or the power of the binomial expansion is even, then we will get a middle term only 1, and if it is odd, then we will get two middle terms. Now corresponding to which terms? So we will get a relation in terms of n, as this is the middle term 5 plus 1 by 2, this can be written as 4 plus 2 by 2, so n plus 2 by 2. Also this is 6 by 2 and 6 by 2 plus 1, that is n plus 1 by 2 and n plus 1 by 2 plus 1, right? Okay, this is third term, 6 by 2 third, 6 means n plus 1, and this is fourth term, which is 6 by 2 plus 1, that is n plus 1 by 2 plus 1. Okay, so there are two cases. First, if n is odd, n is even, then number of terms n plus 1 is odd, right? So there is only one middle term corresponding to the terms n plus 1, this is odd, so middle term will be n plus 1 plus 1 by 2th term, that is n plus 2 by 2, which can be written as n plus 2 by n by 2 plus 1 nth term. So required middle term will be t n by 2 plus 1. Now t means general term. Okay, now we see that in the previous class we know that we have found that if tr plus 1, that is r plus 1th term, this is n by 2 plus 1th term, tr plus 1th term, the formula, general term formula is nc r a to the power r n minus r x to the power r. This is the general term formula. Here first term a, second term x. So here in this example t n by 2 plus 1, that means r equals to n by 2, so by formula nc n by 2 a to the power n minus n by 2 x to the power n by 2. So nc n by 2 a to the power n by 2 x to the power n by 2, right? Now second case, if n is odd, then number of terms n plus 1 is even, so there will be two middle terms corresponding to the terms first term n plus 1 by 2 and second n plus 1 by 2 plus 1. This is the term. Okay. So first middle term will be T n plus 1 by 2. Now we have to written as in that form, r plus 1th form. So we can write it as T n minus 1 by 2 plus 1. Okay. N plus 1 by 2 can be written as n minus 1 by 2 plus 1. So here r equals to n minus 1 by 2. So by formula nc n minus 2 a to the power n minus n minus 1 by 2 into x to the power n minus 1 by 2. So by simplify we can write as a to the power n plus 1 by 2 x to the power n minus 1 by 2. Okay, and second middle term t n plus 1 by 2 plus 1. Here it is already is given in the form tr plus 1, here r equals to n plus 1 by 2. So by formula n plus 1 by 2 a to the power n minus n plus 1 by 2 x to the power n plus 1 by 2 a to the power n plus 1 by sorry n minus 1 by 2 x to the power n plus 1 by 2. So you don't have to know this formula, as for a given problem we can already find from the following manner. So let's see an example how to find a middle term of an expansion. Let's see an example. I have given two examples in the materials. Here I'm doing some different example. Okay. Let's see a given example as x square minus 1 by x whole to the power. Let's see, I'm doing an example which is have two middle terms. Okay, there will be one middle term, there will be two middle terms, it makes no difference. So let's see 30. Okay, so how many middle terms are there for this question? So here n equals to 13. Okay, so n plus 1 equals to 13 plus 1, which is 14. So there will be two middle terms, this is even, so there will be two middle terms, number of terms is even, so middle term will be 2, which is 1 14 by 2th terms and second 14 by 2 plus 1th term corresponding to the terms. These will be the middle terms. Now first that is 7th term and next 8th term. Okay, so we have to find T7, first middle term will be T7 and second middle term will be T8. So first middle term T7 means it can be written as T6 plus 1. So R equals to 6 and N equals to 13. By exam formula we will get 13C6. Here I will T equals to 6. 13C6. A means x square. So x square by formula, general formula, TR plus 1 NCR A to the power R X to the power N A to the power N minus R X to the power R. So here A equals to x square and X equals to, we taking X as minus 1 by X. Okay. So this can be written as in the a plus x whole to the power n. So 13c6 a equals to x square whole to the power n minus r, 13 minus 6. And second, x mean here x is also given as minus 1 by x whole to the power 6. Okay. So 13c6, you can use the calculator. I am using the calculator and giving you the value as, so how to find the 13c3 in calculator. So you can find here NPR and here NCR. Now it is given in the brown color form or yellow color form, right? So how to access this? First on, now NCR, here it is given 13c6. So first we will write 13. Okay, now we have to call NCR. Okay, so as it is yellow, we can now first tap this button, shift, then this button. Okay, sorry, what happened? Oh, sorry, I have first 13, now this is NCR, tap this button, next this button. Okay, you see that C is already happened. Now next 13CR, what is R? 6. So 6 equal to 17, 16. Okay, so we will find 17, 16 into x square whole to the power 7 into, now as the power of the minus is 6, even number, so minus will be plus. Okay, so we will get 1 by x to the power 6. So 176 into x to the power 14 into 1 by x to the power 6. After calculating, we will get x to the power 8. Okay. Now second middle term is second middle term t8. So it can be written as t7 plus 1. Okay. Sorry, 1 minute. T7 plus 1. So here r equals to 7. So by using the formula, we will get 13c7 a equals to x square whole to the power 13 minus 7 and x equals to minus 1 by x whole to the power 7. Okay. So again, we have to find 13c7. So you can just tap this button and delete the last term and put 7. We will get the same number. Okay, 17, 17. As NCR equals to, we will get the same number as NCR equals to NC N minus R. So 13C6 equals to 13C, 13 minus 6, which is 7. 7. So 17, 16. X to the power x square whole to the power 8, and as the power of the minus 1 is 7, so it we will get minus 1 into 1 by x to the power 7. So taking negative term in the front, 1716 x to the power 16 into 1 by x to the power 7, so minus x to the power 9. So these two are the middle terms of the given expansion. Okay, if it is odd, then the middle term will be, if it is an even number, let's say 12, then the number of terms will be 12 plus 1, 13. So middle term will be 13 plus 1 by 2, 7. Okay, in this form you can find the middle terms. Okay, I have given two homeworks and two examples in the materials. Try it yourself. Okay.